Hey guys, this is Joshua Peterson with Peterson Electric. We're here in Northern Colorado tonight. Had a customer call us up, and he knew quite a bit about electricity, so it really helped over the phone. But the main thing he was telling me on the phone, and the main thing that really helped us on the phone, was that he took some pictures and texted it to us. That helped us to know that the meter was outside with the breaker, and that the home's age, how old it was, and that he also knew that there was four wires coming in because he just took the screw off the dead front and he could see. Why that kind of helped was because we were able to kind of guide him through to see if he could reset it. Sometimes it's just hard to get out there in the same day and get that done, but from what he was telling us, this main 100 amp, it's a QO squared D and it would not reset. So what we did is we came out, found a way to get him a temporary splice, and we're going to go research this at one of our secret spots down there in Denver and see if we can find a reconditioned one, and then we're going to try to come back and put that in. So we don't always aim to say, hey, you need a brand new service change. We try to find a way to fix and repair first, because this house really isn't that old and the service isn't that old. What I think was mainly beaten up on this breaker over time, he's a welder and he does a lot of part-time stuff on his side, and I'm starting to think that at 100 amps on the home and welding, and he's got an electrical range, a dryer that's electric, and probably a swamp cooler, and he also I think has a hot water heater. So when those are all electric, sometimes they kick on at once, and if you're welding out in the garage and those items are kicking on, or someone's cooking or cleaning clothes, that juice going through this breaker over time will wear it down, and welders create a lot of arc. So keep in mind, guys, if you're going to get a hot tub or a welder, you might want to look at upgrading your service to at least a 150. 200 amps is the best bet that you could put on a smaller single-family dwelling. But anyways, we're here tonight. It's almost 11 p.m. We got this wrapped up for them. We did it in about an hour, hour and a half. And we'll try to find a solution and let him know in the next 48 hours what we can do. Thanks, guys, for joining us. Have a great week.